Well, my name is Corey Dinkens, the technical marketing architect for Tanzu Mission Control. And as Pradeep said, my background is really in operational type role. So the way I look at like a lot of how I use Tanzu Mission Control is through that lens. So, you know, if I have a cluster running and a workload running, how do I back this up securely? How do I restore it? And how do I ensure continuity for my business? You know, those are all the questions that I'm really asking when I think about issues like this. So to start, let's take a look at a cluster that I actually have running in Amazon in the EKS service. So first, the first thing that you have to do for any cluster is enable data protection. Once that's turned on, and I guess the act of doing this is what initiates and deploys Velero for you onto these clusters. So once we've done that, we actually will have access to this data protection tab. And what you can see in here, there's a little bit of information that tells you how Velero has been deployed, some of the different settings that you've chosen for that deployment. And then you can also see your different backups that you have taken and any schedules that you may have created. So real quickly, let's just take a quick look at how you would initiate and create a backup. So as you can see here, what Nandish and Pradeep were referring to frequently were the ability to scope out how you want your backups. So do you want the entire cluster? Are you just after a namespace because maybe, you know, a certain application has gotten corrupted and that's really what you're trying to restore? It just really depends on what your needs are. You can even go so far as to back up your objects only using label selectors. So we can do things like you have a Helm deployment and we can match it to things like, you know, the deployment name or the chart name, for example. And then you can also even exclude resources. So I know there are instances for, I believe it's the Entrea CNI, where we must exclude all of the different webhooks and stuff that are included, or else the restorers won't succeed correctly, for lack of a better phrase. And then you can also include cluster scoped resources, which are really things that were created locally on the cluster you're backing up that normally would not just be present on the one that you're restoring to. So an example of that might be something like a service account or maybe some config maps, things of that sort. So moving on into the next screen, we now have the choice to select which type of backups we would like to use. Now, I currently do not have the snapshot functionality enabled on this cluster, but if I did, I would be able to choose it and we could do our crash consistent backups of our databases. I guess pretty much databases and anything that has, data in memory that you need to capture, this is the route that you'd want to go. So after that, we can then choose our backup location. And as Pradeep was saying, we have the choices of S3, Amazon S3 targets or Azure Blob targets. So depending on where you've got your clusters running, you have the flexibility to back up to targets that might be local to those clusters and essentially avoid huge egress charges from a cloud provider. So for example, if you have a cluster that has a lot of data on it in Amazon, generally don't want to back it up to Azure just through the standard methods because it could cause you a lot of egress fees. So you can choose the backup target that is most appropriate for your environment and one that will potentially save you time and money. So next, we can choose when we want to back this up. So this is where essentially we create our schedule. And we can essentially create a custom cron job if we would like to, but I would say for most cases, many people are going to utilize the hourly, daily type of backup scenarios. But in this case, we're just going to choose now because we want to take an immediate and click next. We set our retention period. We give the backup a name. So in this case, date. So I don't think that actually completed because it looked like my session timed out right when I tried to do that. But that's what the backup creation process looks like. It's really should be pretty familiar to you if you've used any of the common VI backup tools such as Veeam, etc. So now what I want to do is I want to take that backup that we had just captured, or one of the ones that I captured previously, and I want to actually restore it to this Azure AKS cluster that we've attached here. And this is something that is pretty simple to do. We essentially make sure that the Velero data protection has been enabled. And then once it's enabled, we can click restore from another cluster. And we're able to choose the different clusters that we've actually created backups in. So as you can see from that backup screen, we've got our two choices here. I can choose one of these backups, and then I can click next. And this is where we actually have the reverse of the backup screen, where we can essentially choose what resources we would actually like to restore. So if we don't want to restore the entire backup, we don't have to do that. And if we want to restore to different namespaces as well, we can do that too, right? So pretty powerful. And you can also include the cluster scoped resources that I was referring to earlier. So if you want to include things like service accounts, stuff like that, you can do that. And you can also instruct Velero to update any existing resources. So if there's a config map that exists that you want to ensure is overwritten with the latest info, this is the option you'd want to pick. And then again, we would also be able to choose which volumes we wanted to restore. And in this case, because I did the full backup, we're going to restore all of them. So we click next, give this a name. And then we would go through the restore process.